13 operators have applied to the local government of Cagayan to dredge the 300-kilometer-long Cagayan River. This is according to Cagayan Governor Manuel Mamba, who says the project has been in the pipeline for 4 months with the help of different government agencies. The first phase of the project will involve the desilting of 32 kilometers of the river. Mamba notes they won't spend any funds for the project and even earn from it.
It is now becoming our gold mine. Dahil yung tatanggalin po dyan, maibibenta po eh. Malilibre po namin dahil they will do it for free. Kikita pa ho kami. Babayad pa sila ng quarry fees nila and then excise tax po nila.
The project comes as Typhoon Ulysses battered the province last week and caused massive flooding. Water levels in the town of Alcala are now slowly subsiding. Alcala Mayor Cristina Antonio says they are now focused on clearing operations, especially inside villages covered in mud. Antonio adds they are in dire need of food, water, and hygiene kits.
I'm sure marami ang na-damage ang houses, totally and partially damaged. Dahil walang mga belongings na natira ang mga tao, naiyanod na sa baha. Walang damit, walang blankets, wala pong naitira.
In Lalo, Cagayan, water levels have also gone down, but many houses remain submerged. Their mayor, Oliver Pascual, says aid has been given to the residents.
Isabela, Governor Rodito Albano III calls on the national government to help solve the persistent flooding in the Cagayan River Basin. Albano says local officials cannot find the solution to flooding alone due to lack of resources. Meanwhile, Albano says they're now focused on enforcing health protocols for COVID-19. This is as he admits it would be challenging to test all their evacuees for the disease.
Hindi po kaya ng mga local governments to. Ang mga local government magpo-provide lang ng management, pero ang data gathering ay manggagaling talaga sa national government. Na kailangan sila yung mga una dito, sila yung may mga resources.